today I'm going to talk about mechanobiology and RNA sequencing. So when you see many papers regarding mechanobiology or any cell biology, nowadays researchers perform RNA sequencing a lot. So when you saw very, very beautiful images, most of them are from the RNA sequencing. So I'm going to tell you briefly how RNA sequencing is being used, and then how you can analyze based on our company's protocol and their software. So the basic concept of RNA sequencing is, let's see, in vivo, this is DNA in the genome, and then exon, intron, exon, intron, exon, this is called pre-mRNA. And then after intron splicing, exon only translate to the mature mRNA, okay? But in vitro, in your hand, or when you do PCR or RNA sequencing, mRNA is extracted from the organism, fragmented, and then copied into the stable double-stranded cDNA. So like this, this RNA fragment, so this RNA is very unstable, so they should be copied into the stable double-stranded cDNA, like this blue, very stable. And then from this double-stranded cDNA, it's sequenced and using high throughput short-read sequencing method. So can you see this little letter? So this blue are sequenced by the high throughput sequencing method. And then at that time, and then after that, you can get this kind of single fragment. So this sequence can then be aligned to the reference genome sequence to reconstruct which genome regions are being transcribed. So which means, so originally this fragment is not aligned like this. We didn't know how they aligned. So you can get from this blue many like 10 or 20 fragment, and then somehow, but we have reference genome, maybe human, we have human genome, and mouse genome. So we try to align this little fragment to our original, this genome sequencing. And then from this genome sequencing, and then this machine can count how many fragment set are aligned to specific genome. Let's say this is a 5, 3, 5. And then let's say this three domain is consist of one genome, let's say OCN, osteocalcin, and then you can read 5 read from the OCN. But three read from this variant A, but the other two is from variant B. Okay? So how we know the RNA is expressed? From when they aligned it, and then how many aligned sequencing sets are positioned in your specific genome, and then they count automatically the read number. This is a basic concept of the RNA sequencing. So let's say you have control, like tumor, and then, control normal, and experiment human and tumor sample, and then you can isolate RNA from tissue, and then from the RNA, and then from the cDNA change, and then from the cDNA to the sequencing method, you can get many fragments. And then now, these fragments are aligned in our genome reference. And then from this genome reference, we can read how many fragments are aligned into our specific genome and gene, and then we can know the exact RNA reading numbers. So this and then another RNA sequencing method is quantSeq. QuantSeq is more known to more matched to a result from the qPCR. So when you have some data from the qPCR, and then you can, when you do quantSeq, the matches will be more similar. So what is a quantSeq? RNA sequencing, they read all this coding sequencing plus 3' UTR region. But in quantSeq, they read like code 3' UTR region plus little coding sequence area. So more fast, and then more fast and more cheap. But one drawback is quantSeq, you cannot know the variant of the mRNA. So if you really want to know the variant of mRNA, you have to read to perform RNA sequencing total, but just you want to know the, their expression level, and then quantSeq, you have to choose. So quantSeq, just you can say like array, they only know the code in specific gene, and then using this code, they can read the RNA expression. And then this is single cell RNA sequencing. So from the previous RNA sequencing and quantSeq, they all analyze bulk cell. Bulk cell means if you put 100 million cell, you can know the average from the 100 million cell of the RNA. But in single cell RNA, you can analyze the RNA data from the single cell. So once you sort the cell from the tissue, and then after single cell isolation, you can get RNA from the single cell level and convert to cDNA and amplify RNA, and then cDNA again, and then align to library and sequencing and get the result. So specifically, they are used for sorting the cell types. So if you collect the cell from the tumor tissue, some of them tumor, some of them immune cell, some of them just normal cell, they're all mixed. So if you perform RNA sequencing total, bulk RNA sequencing, you can get average value from the this total immune cell, cancer cell, normal cell. But if you cluster the single cell and then only get the RNA data from the tumor cell, you can see more clear difference of the tissue. So this is very important. So choice of RNA sequencing. So bulk mRNA sequencing, you can investigate general mRNA in average. So you need total RNA amount 2 microgram. And then normally they suggest 100 microgram per microliter, and then 20 microliter volume. So which means total 2 microgram is needed by nanodrop. But when we send our sample, they perform again using bioanalyzer to check the quality and quantity of the RNA. And then you can know the average RNA data of your cells, and then isoform expression, just before, and then single nucleopeptide analysis, SNP analysis, and then splicing variant. So when you want to know the some variants or some isoform of mRNA or some certain mutation, the best choice is for RNA sequencing, mRNA. But you only want to know the their expression level, not investigating detail about some isoform variation or mutation of the mRNA. quantSeq is more relevant. quantSeq is more relevant to qPCR result, and then cheaper, and then need small concentration. This is very important for us because we are using a lot of matrix or some biomaterial. In that case, RNA extraction is not easy. So in that case, quantSeq is more relevant. quantSeq, for just in case, cells or matrix, you can perform a lot, and then they need small RNA concentration. Theoretically, when they have 10 to 100 nanogram only, they can perform. This is 20 or 2,000 times less than original RNA sequencing. Very less amount you can get, So they said as a nanodrop, 5 nanogram per microliter, 20 microliter of total volume RNA, and then total amount 100 nanogram by nanodrop. And then they check again by their bioanalyzer, and then when they get passed, you can perform. So quantity is like that. And then you can perform another RNA sequencing, like small RNA sequencing. Normally, for small RNA sequencing, you can analyze microRNA. So after pretty fine exosome from your cells, media, and then exosome RNA should be over 10 nanogram. So they check concentration of RNA, 1 nanogram per microliter, more or less, and then volume minimum 20 microliter. So when you want to know the microRNA, which microRNA in your exosome or your conditioned media, you have to perform this microRNA spatial sequencing. And also you can perform bacterial RNA sequencing. So you have to use special RNA isolation kit, not from just our normal isolation. You have to use special isolation kit for bacterial RNA. So this is another one. And then what is the price? Price per sample is like $500 to $700 per sample. In case of QuantSeq, cheaper than just small RNA or mRNA. So they like that. So, and then how many N number you have to perform? So normally in high impact journal, without any qPCR confirmation, they say at least 3 times. So N number should 3. For example, we have one control and one experiment group, and then 2 group, right? And then you have 3, 3. So total 6. So 6 multiply by $500, $30,000. $3,000, yeah, like that. But actually this is too much for us. So when you want to check just one control on one experiment, and then after checking their phenomenon, and then you want to know, you want to say maybe this pathway can be involved, should be involved in your experiment, and then you can analyze again. From your RNA sequencing data, you can get some clue, and then you have to perform Western blot or qPCR for proving your hypothesis. In that case, N number one is also okay. And in material scientists, they are not familiar that much about RNA sequencing, so sometimes they allowed N number one, even without proving the result. So, this like that. And then another version of the RNA sequencing is single cell RNA sequencing, scRNA sequencing. So when you send your sample 10 to 6 power cell in 14 milliliter media, the cell viability should be over 90%. And then when you gather the cell, primary cell or FACS40 cell, the cell number at least 40,000 cell in media, the viability should be 70%. And then after getting the cell from the tissue or from your cell, you have to deliver your cell to the company in Seoul. So cell viability should be over 70 to 90% after delivery to company. But when they failed, you have to ask in-house service for preparation, which means you can request, please come to iTrain, and then prepare the cell. And then when you just have your cell, so one special professional person will come to the lab, and then they will prep your cell. And then it will cost around $500, but it's more cheaper than multiple delivery. And then in that case, even though you send sample cell around 40,000 or many number of cells, the single cell RNA sequencing, they only analyze 5,000 cells. maximum. Not all. Okay? So, but price is 10 times expensive. $5,000 to $6,000 per sample. And all this sequencing take 4 to 5 weeks. Okay? So when you visit our collaborator company is eBiogen. So when you visit eBiogen website, you can see this kind of total RNA, this bulk RNA, or mRNA sequencing data. They need 2 microgram total, and then blah, 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 4 weeks. You can do tissue, cell, whole blood, something like. And QuantSeq, QuantSeq is, they allow very small amount of RNA. And then, yeah, a little bit shorter than bulk RNA sequencing, 3 weeks. But sometimes more or less. In case of bacteria, also, bacteria, they need special, like, RNA isolation kit, because they have to delete rRNA, ribosome RNA. So, like that, 4 weeks. And then they can only allow the bacteria species enrolled in NCBI database. And the summarized sequencing, this is for exosome or microRNA. So, they allow 2 microgram total from tissue or exosome, in exosome case, a small amount. So if you have only tissue or cell, so this 2,000 nanogram total you need. But when you collect the RNA from the exosome or body fluid, very small amount, and then also it's also possible. And then single cell RNA sequencing, in case of cell line, yeah, like this cell, and then primary cell like this. So it will take, only they allowed 5,000 cell. It take 5 weeks. Okay, I have a question. You are culturing neuron cell on PCA fiber, or you are culturing macrophage on PAA gel. Which method will you choose? Bulk mRNA sequencing, QuantSeq, small RNA sequencing, single cell RNA sequencing. Actually, the answer is you can perform everything if you have enough amount and enough cell. But most of the case, in case of fiber, the RNA concentration is very small. Compared to TCP and bulk 2D film, in case of fiber, 1-3 scaffold, the RNA amount is very small. So I suggest QuantSeq, just 10 nanogram, or 100 nanogram is also okay for performing RNA sequencing. Okay? In case of PAA gel, also you can perform very big size of PAA gel sometimes, but if you only have very small size, like 10 millimeter or 20 millimeter of PAA gel, I suggest QuantSeq. Number two, you treat nanoparticle treatment in mesenchymal stem cell, or you are culturing neuron stem cell on 2D film. Compared to example one, maybe you can get more amount of the RNA. So I suggest mRNA sequencing or bulk RNA sequencing. Because additionally, you can get some RNA variation or some mutation sometimes. So you can get more data. Example three, you are reprogramming cell on the matrix, or you are getting primary cultured immune cell on matrix, and then maybe single cell RNA sequencing is a proper way to do. Because when you reprogram the cell, some cell is original cell, some other cell, they are reprogrammed. So cell types can be mixed. So in that case, better to do RNA sequencing and single cell RNA sequencing. In case immune cell, there are many immune cell. T cell, B cell, macrophage, neutrophil, or in case of CD4 plus, CD8 plus, many kind of T cell also you can see. So in that case, when you culture the primary culture immune cell on the matrix, and then to know how immune cell behave change, suggest single cell RNA sequencing. So let's assume you send your sample to the company. So for example, I got the data from the Pinky. Pinky nowadays is culturing this system. So SHAD is a primary PERP stem cell in baby tooth. Okay, and then also human gingival fibroblast you can get from the oral mucosa from the patient, normal patient. So we want to accelerate this PERP stem cell proliferation, cell survival, migration, and differentiation for clinical application. So this PERP stem cell, they are originally located in this tooth. Sometimes they are infected or from the tooth decay. Or from the trauma, your PERP can be exposed to the oral microenvironment. In that case, the PERP cell can be necrosis, and then they are dying. In that case, we want to save or make them survive. In that case, we want to use conditioned media from human gingival fibroblast to regenerate the PERP stem cell. That is our hypothesis. So we perform many things, and then we check the, so this all data from the SHAD cell, PERP stem cell, but we treat just control means differentiation media. And then this SF means serum-free media, because when you collect the conditioned media from the gingival fibroblast, you always have to use serum-free media. So serum-free media without conditioned cell, just media itself can be used to control. And then conditioned media is from the human gingival fibroblast. And then we heat treat it to degrade all cytokine, or all component of the conditioned media. So we expect conditioned media have some effect compared to serum-free media. And then when we heat treat it, this effect can be gone, because all important cytokine or growth factor can be damaged from the heat treatment. We heat treat it 95 degree, 5 minutes around to degrade it, to remove all growth factor efficacy. So we saw some good event in case of DMP1. DMP1 is marker of odontoblast, PERP stem cell differentiation. DMP1 is enhanced in conditioned media, and other ocean lungs too is especially enhanced in blue conditioned media. And then when you check iodine red staining, day 14, day 21, iodine red is a finer differentiation status of the PERP stem cell into odontoblast. So they stain the calcium. So like this, conditioned media has more red color than other serum-free or heat treatment conditioned media in case of day 14. And then when you check based on the ALP staining, also you can clearly saw the good event, more color change in conditioned media. So Pinky and me decided to send our sample at day 7 to check how this conditioned media is differentiated to the odontoblast better than heat treatment conditioned media and serum-free media. So we want to know the mechanism through the PMP pathway or from another some metabolic change. So we want to know how and why this conditioned media is good for PERP stem cell differentiation. So we got the result from our company, and then from the company protocol, you can get this kind of Excel file, which is called Xtega. Before this software, it's not easy to analyze by yourself. But this eBiogen company, they gratefully make this software to analyze your data by yourself. So you can analyze the data in your mind. without any further request. So you can get this kind of some graph change, how up and down genes are located in which gene ontology. I will show you later in specifically. And then this kind of some scattering plot, volcano plot, and then diagram, and then heat map also you can get. So this kind of single genes, how they are differentially expressed. And then yeah, you can get this hierarchical clustering, like maybe if you have 2 or 3 or 10 sample, how they are clustered, how they are similar, how they are far away. And then from the geothermal analysis, which kind of genes set are expressed in your sample compared to other sample. And then you can also check the KEG pathway. KEG is just institute or software name. So you can catch which kind of pathway can be involved. So sometimes from the red upregulated gene, this is involved in your gene set, blue downregulated gene, and then they show how many pathways are involved. And then from this pathway result, you can perform qPCR and then Western blot or inhibitor study to prove your hypothesis. And then, like this, maybe in Nature sister journal or science, you can get this kind of enrichment data. So you can also get this enrichment data. So I will show you one by one, maybe. So as I shared with you, this is after installing the eBiogen software, and then through the Excel file, you can get this. Platform. So after set up your eBiogen Xtega software, you can perform start, click the start. So here you can get this gene category left, and then differentiatedly expressed analysis, DEG. So first, you have three samples. Condition media, heat treatment condition media, and serum free media condition. Okay? So you treat three different media to the purpose stem cell. And then after 7 days of differentiation using this media, we collect the cell, extract the RNA, and send our sample to the company. And then we got this result. So this is the normalized data, log 2. This is their normal data without log scale. So if you log 2, this 5.4, maybe this value can be obtained. And then for this, low data also you can get another as a RC, and then you can know the KEG input information from this, and then which gene, how they are ID, and where they are located, chromosome, and what is their starting point, ending point, and width of the gene, and the transcript ID number, some biotype, allies and other description. So this, what is the meaning of this gene? So alpha 1 beta glycoprotein, like that. And then NCBI search, this is some abbreviation of your gene information. And then from this RNA sequencing, we get 24,424 gene, number one. This ID is from our company, and then like that. Okay, total this number. And then We want to know how our gene set are fold changed. So we need some control group. Actually, we request some reverse this, this one. But let's say, so from this fold change, some group is below, some group is up. So let's say, I want to know, you can change fold change of this, or normalized data, log to this, and p-value. P-value means if we perform number two or number three, and number three in each group, you can use this p-value. But in our case, we are only using n number one, so we don't use it, p-value. So first, I want to know from the condition media, compared to condition media, which gene set are highly or negatively expressed in heat treatment condition media. So click both. You can also click up and down. Okay, up, down like that. So I check both. And then the fold chain should be, let's say, 1.5. And then you can get, like, from the 20,000 gene, only 57 you can categorize. And then, actually, depending on their original read number, some genes are highly read, some genes are less read, right? So you can say maybe more read number means more RNA expressed. So more RNA expressed can be more relevant. So you, when you increase this normalized data, like 8, you can get the differentially expressed gene, but their original read number is over 8. 양 많은 거 할 수 있는 거죠. 양 많은 거. But when you decrease this normalized data to 2, you can get more genes, which means even you can include the small read number genes. So it totally depends on you. So in our case, so I try to do like that. 4. Okay? 4. So according to this only condition media and heat treatment condition media, so like that, you can categorize. So I okay, they allowed. So for quantification, I like that. So for change number 2 is less than 0.5, right? Or over 2 here. So you can get only gene set less than 0.5 and over 2. So, oh, this kind of gene is related. And then you can get the information from your this description. Oh, some genes are insulin growth factor and interferon induced something, some chemokine, CXC, TGF-beta. Some of them you are familiar with them, but some of them you are not familiar. So what is the meaning of this? And then we can use this gene category. So I checked aging from this gene. Is there any gene related to the aging? Nothing. Oh, not related to the aging. Angiogenesis? Oh, some of them are involved. Okay. So cell differentiation. Oh, heat treatment highly decreasing, right? So it makes sense. It makes sense. So maybe cell death? Some gene up, some gene down. Okay. So many inflammation response or down. Where secretion, sometimes you can call this when you click end, some gene related to the inflammation response plus cell differentiation. And then, oh, only these two categories are involved. Gene is this number C3. But you want to click or some gene either here or there. So depending on your taste, you can click and sort. So you can also change these two small numbers. So I want to increase it, 1.5. And then you can get more, like 22. Also, this gene category is not satisfactory for your condition. Because in our case, we are checking odontoblast differentiation. So maybe differentiation, it makes sense. But maybe your hypothesis, like maybe some BMP-related gene can be involved. So I want to add gene category. In that case, click gene category setting. And then import. Sorry. From the import, you click website. So from this website, you can go QuickGeo annotation homepage. Let's say, or mechanoreceptor differentiation. Let's just assume, okay, regulation method differentiation, check. And then taxon is, so this is all 517 annotation gene are categorized in this gene geo term, gene ontology term. But in that case, we have to specify our sample to human, right? You click the Homo sapiens, and then apply. From 500, only 13 annotation is sorted, okay? And then you export maybe this GIF, and then they only allowed maximum is like that, but I only have 13, so this is okay. Go. And then this, I can get this geo, new geo term. And then you put this geo term, sorry. Geo in desktop file here. You can get this geo. This geo, and then go back to your Excel file. So import, click geo, and then you rename the geo like mechano regulation. Then you got one new category, right? Okay, and then you click mechanical regulation, maybe nothing. But just without this click, and then when you check mechanical regulation, maybe 13 genes are located, assigned to your mechanical regulation geoterm. And another way, just you can get this from some PCR array geo, gene category. From human, mouse, rat, let's say already this comes gene set related to the drug metabolism, cancer, glucose metabolism. So maybe I feel like, let's say maybe hypoxia signaling pathway can be involved. So I, here, osteogenesis. I click osteogenesis and then import. And then this is osteogenesis, okay. Oh, maybe osteo and odonto, very similar, both of them. So this, I newly added osteogenesis category. So let's see how many osteogenesis are involved like that. Oh, okay. Some, this BMP or collagen and FGF integrin are assigned to this osteogenesis geoterm. So we can get this. Or another way, you can make new geoterm by yourself, like mine. And then you can add the gene name here, like BMP2, or CTGF, something like. You can make your own geoterm here. So you can add it. Okay, so I show you how they are changed. And then sometimes you want to unclick all of them and then show view all data. And then they show view all data. And then from this gene category, sometimes after sorting the data like this from 50, and then how many genes in here only from this 50 7 from the this conditioned media treatment, how these genes are located in this gene category, you click it, and then they show like that. So some up gene is located aging, and then other, some down gene located in certain, GO gene category doesn't have any genes of interest. And then what is the meaning of this? 1.26, which means in immune response, the total gene is 1,590 gene. From that, your 20 genes are involved. So this is called 1.26%. Okay? So from this percentage, maybe how my gene set are related to certain gene, you can expect. You can see. So you can add more gene category or you can remove it to show this one. So in this case, we can say that maybe angiogenesis is very highly involved. Oh. Okay, also when you check significant chart, this chart is when you perform N number 3 or over N number 2, yeah, you can get this data. So what is analysis graph? Let's click scatter plot. So I want to compare this hit, let's say, from the conditioned media and serum-free media, and then for change to up red, down green, view graph. And then, oh, this is within 4-chain 2, up and down. And when you click this gene, this gene is highly upregulated. And some gene is highly downregulated. So, I can guess which gene is more high, more up from this graph, okay? And then you want to say, where is BMP2 here? BMP2 at? ID number, let's say, H641 at here. Oh, this is here. Okay, you can, from this ID number, using this Xtega software, you want to know, you can catch where the gene is located in your graph, okay? Sometimes you can click, which gene is highly unregulated? Click. This SNQ, something like. Okay, got it. Also, you can change this 4-chain, 1.5, 4-chain, and then they are more decreasing, narrowed it, and 4, 5, graph view, they are more enlarged, okay? And then depending on how you 100%, and 70%, and each way, and then you can save the image here. Okay? So maybe you can get some target gene in your mind or from your analysis, and then using this scatter plot, you can highlight. Our gene set, maybe one, these five genes is related to the BMP. So I want to say this differentiation is through the BMP signaling pathway. So these BMP genes are highly located. So I want to say maybe BMP signaling can be involved. And then Venn diagram, so when you click NS2, show Venn diagram. When you click 2 or so, you can show. For change to normal data, the real value of their value, maybe you can increase like 2, and they are also decreasing. For change, you can enhance like that, also decreasing. So depending on how you categorize, you can see. So this A is, this upper, like slightly tilted one is unregulated in heat treatment condition media. And then this with line is downregulated. With red color, contra. Contra means from these two, one is unregulated. But from here, T this gene is downregulated. So this is contra. So when you want to know, oh, which gene is upregulated here, so when you click this number 2, double click it, or upregulated, they only show, oh, this gene is upregulated in here. And when you show region O, these 7 genes are detected. And then when you click here, gene O, all these 10, 14 genes are located here. So specifically, you can catch and know which genes are related. And then, next one is KEK pathway. Yeah. Today, I'm going to briefly show you this KEK pathway, and then next week, I will show more in detail. So, for KEK pathway, okay, let's imagine this, I want to know from the, I only select this down, because, from here, maybe unclick. From conditioned media, have some effect compared to this serum-free media. So I only select which kind of gene are down-regulated in this serum-free media, so down. And then I can get 95 gene here. So copy and paste this gene symbol. Ctrl-C, and then you can go to David. So start analysis. So David is some internet software to analyze your data set. So pass a list of your gene here, and then select identify less genome. This one, right? Official gene symbol, and then gene list, click and submit. Step 2. Ah, where is it? Ah, human. Homo. Like this? Yeah, Homo sapiens, yes. And then I put 95, but only 93 is related, so it's okay. So, and then this is done in the software. So I can get this data. Ah, where should I click? This one? Okay. So let's say there are many. So in your gene set, some disease are related. Click. And then let's say from your gene, maybe 22.6% is located in here. They are used for analyze about this gene. No result. So red one is they are recommended. So maybe if you put this gene set, maybe they suggest cardiovascular, metabolic, or pharmacogenomic, some disease are related. So your gene, 30 are involved in this category. And then this cardiovascular term, maybe they have maybe 10,000 gene set in this category. From that, when you put 95, among 95, 30 is involved. So based on this database, they analyze p-value. Okay, so according to their p-value, they show like that. So this can be involved in our gene set. Okay, next. It's important. Functional. So functional means, let's say from the up keyword. So maybe some phosphoprotein or mitosis or centromere. These are cytoskeleton, they are involved. And then when you click it, you can see which gene are located from your input. So these genes are related to this category. So some up keyword, and this one. So certain domain, you can see. This can be involved. Actually, this geo term is very important. Geo, BP is a biological process, CC is cell component, MF is molecular function. Okay, molecular function. So from this BP, you can see many of them, but most of people, they click direct or all. So let's see direct. So which kind of biological process are involved in your gene set input? Positive regulation of ubiquitin, cell division, ECM organization, blah, blah, blah. Oh, osteoblast differentiation. Maybe these biological processes are decreasing, right? Decreasing in our serum-free medium. And when it makes sense, you can highlight from the top 10 BP, maybe your target biological pathway is involved. So I can say, generally, this gene set show some decreasing of like ECM organization or cell division or osteoblast differentiation. You can say like that. And then from that, which kind of cell component is downregulated? You click it. Maybe ECM downregulated, cytosol or condensed chromosome or extra space, these are downregulated. Also, if you have some clue or idea how you link this CC data to your manuscript, so you can say from the differentiation, ECM and cytosol should be highly expressed, but serum-free media, they are decreasing. So we can say our differentiation condition from the condition media is better than serum-free media. From ECM decreasing here. So this all gene set, all CC data is from the decreasing gene set. So I can say this is decreasing. If we put unregulated gene, you can say this CC is increasing. If you put both high and up, you can say they are involved. And then function. Some molecular function is maybe ATP binding decreasing, have protein binding decreasing. Something are decreasing here because I put decreasing gene set. But if you put increasing gene set, those function can be enhanced. Okay. So briefly, you can say these things are involved generally. And then other like general annotation like chromosome or from literature or main accessory, you can see and how they are localized. But important thing is that pathway. Here they show pathway 5, but KEK pathway is very well known. So 37 genes are used. Let's see KEK pathway. From the KEK pathway, nothing is obtained, unfortunately. And then you can add more gene set or up and down both of them. So let's see this reactome pathway. Reactome is some reaction-related protein, reactome. Some protein reaction is involved. So this kind of protein is involved in your gene set. Okay, what is your biocarta? Nothing there. So, and then protein domain, let's say, how protein from your gene set are related. So maybe from your gene set, this first one can be selected. First one can be more. First one is decreasing. So you can knock down study of first one protein. But only two is involved from your 95. Protein interaction, yeah. And tissue expression, maybe which kind of tissue are involved. So maybe this epithelium tissue can be involved in your gene set. Say like that. So this is general analysis of your gene set. So next week, I will analyze another like gene enrichment, some any other platform. So before coming next week, please analyze the data by yourself, because so I suggest as a final exam, you can, when you open your install file, you can see this kind of file, and then you can access sample data like this, XDAGA. So until this CAG pathway analysis, you can make it and copy and paste in your PPT. Okay? So what should you have done? You have to make GO and gene category set and capture input. And then you try to change this fold chain and normalized data, and then show me the scatter plot, volcano plot, Venn diagram, and filter gene category, everything. And then lastly, you collect some gene set from your XDAGA file, and then make the analyzed by David software, and then put the data in your PPT. Yeah, until next week. Okay? You can use this data. Okay, any question in detail, you can find our Kakao group chat room. I share one English version and Korean version of manual, so you can see in detail. So if you have question, first, you can ask your colleague, or senior, or junior. After questioning, you cannot resolve the problem. Just bring it here next week. Okay, thank you.